In this episode, we're going to talk about Geneva movements and rendering within SOLIDWORKS. Believe it or not, you have learned enough now to be able to create a model like this Geneva movement, and I'm going to show you how. So let's get started. As you can see here, we have the Geneva movement, and I've spent a little time creating it, but I haven't used any techniques that haven't been taught in the previous episodes. So let's just take a look at this assembly. You can see here we have a knob, and if you turn it, it locks what's called an intermittent movement into place until it reaches this point, at which time it begins to advance the mechanism, obviously by a sixth of a turn. Now, I haven't set up boundaries to allow the mechanism to move, but you could get more into detail if you wanted to actually see this work on the screen. We can use it so that we can see if all the parts fit correctly, and it looks pretty good. You may want to add a little space there in the future, but for this lesson, it's really not important. Let's just look at how we created this assembly and then take a look at the rendering. If you remember from previous episodes, we just simply created parts and then brought them in through assemblies. We then added mates. Let's look at a few of the mates. If we look at this one here, I'll delete it just so we can show you how it works. We now have parts that are moving up and down because they're not locked into place through a mate. So let's re-add that mate. Remember, we go assembly, mate. We're gonna clear these, we're gonna select the bottom, and then we're gonna select the part that it mates to. And now that's locked into place. We also have to lock this one into place, select there, and here. And now it's locked into place again. And we still are able to rotate it, able to rotate the knob, so we're good to go. Once we have all our mates, we're going to want to make a realistic 3D model of this Geneva movement. Let's see how we do that. We're going to go into Render Tools. We're going to go into Options. And we're just going to select 1920 by 1080, which is the same aspect ratio that videos are using here on YouTube. So we'll just leave it at that. We can go down to the bottom and make sure we have Preview is good. And I like to do best for the final render quality. It depends on your processing speed, but this is a MacBook Pro and it has 8 cores, so it's pretty good. So we're gonna hit okay. Now we need to place the object in the center of the screen where we think, approximately where we think it's gonna render. And we need to select some looks. There are a bunch of choices for your background. We can do everything from spotlights to plain white to a fade. For this, I'm just going to do plain white. So we want to move it around until we kind of get the position that we like. Then we're going to hit the preview window. And we're still able to move it around a little bit. It's a little tricky depending on your processor. But if you move the mouse, we are able to tilt it to the way we want. Then we just simply hit final render. Now this can take a few minutes depending on your processing power. If it's a really complex part, it can actually take a few hours or even a day. Let's just let it run and then we'll get back to taking a look at it. You can see the processors. The neat thing about SOLIDWORKS, those little box represents each core of the processors. So it shows you that all 8 are working. In this particular model, I used a lot of chrome and aluminum with color. You can also see the reflections in the base plate. That's the neat thing about photorealistic renderings. And now what we're gonna do is save the image. And let's open our picture. And there's our full rendering. Now, don't be intimidated by this. It really is simple. All you have to do is go back through the lessons and you can get to this point of making a Geneva movement. I hope you've enjoyed this episode, and please don't forget to subscribe to our channel.